friends, and welcome to the video. First of all, I'm trying my new microphone. Supposedly this is one of the best, so let's see how it works. So hopefully you guys have a better experience with all these tools. But anyways, the point of the video, guys, is time for Tutor. And I'm really, really excited because this is one of the watches that I've been waiting for to see. And this is one of the new ones that just came out actually this year. This is the new Black Bay 58 with sterling silver case. Very, very interesting watch, my friends. We haven't seen anything like this since probably the 50s, if I'm mistaken, or if you remember one of the last models that was practically silver case, please let me know in the comments below. I would really appreciate that because I really wanna know. But I really think we haven't seen something like this probably in around 50, 60 years. At the end of the day, I think this is a very interesting piece, and I just wanted to give you guys a closer look to this amazing piece. So if you want to be on top to every model to be released from different brands, please subscribe to my YouTube channel, give us a like, tell me what you think. It's free and it's really going to help this channel a lot. So putting that out there, I think it's time to take a look at this watch and take it out of the box. So let's take a look at it. Okay, my friends, now it's time to take this beautiful watch out of the box, and you guys already know I can help you with more brands, such as probably with Tudor. I don't think we have a lot of restrictions at this moment, such as Rolex, but if you're looking for any other brands, such as Tag Heuer, Cartier, Bulgari, Hublot, Gucci, anything you're looking for, please contact me on the links below, tell me what are you looking for, and hopefully I can help you build your collection. Unfortunately, with Rolex, I have more and more restrictions, so let's see how it's going to be in the future. Hopefully you guys can find those watches easier, right? But anyways, let's take a look at this amazing watch. And first of all, I want to compare. Of course, I know we have anything to compare, and I know in my last video, I was saying that probably I will go for the watch. To be honest, I really like the watch. I will definitely give more use to this particular watch more than the silver bar, but I understand, of course, I definitely understand that this is a much better probably investment. I don't know what's going to happen in the future with the watches, but as far as silver, it's been a very, very secure investment on the past probably hundreds of years, right? I don't know exactly. But at the end of the day, this is a very beautiful watch, very cool case. It's a 39 millimeter in space, and the price, it's very, very affordable. If we compare this to other models such as Hublot, Cartier, and Rolex, I think this is a very nice piece. Has a great mechanism. It's made by Rolex. Besides that, it's also a silver case. It's sterling silver case, 925. I think that's great. We haven't seen anything like this. To me personally, I really will enjoy this watch a lot, and you guys can see here in the video, it has a very different look. I love the matte finish of the watch. The case, of course, this is not a stainless steel metal. Of course, the stainless steel, to me, I think it looks more like shiny. And with the silver, you guys can see, it's more like a matte. It does have a reflection, but I think it's a different type of reflection. I love how it looks. Very, very cool watch, my friends, 39 millimeters. Also, one of the things that I love, and I really think this is going to practically give Tudor their own identity, because a lot of people, like watch fan guys, they don't really like a lot Tudor because they think it's kind of like a copy of Rolex, or they're very similar to Rolex. If you ask me personally, I don't see it as a copy. I see it as a brother or as a cousin or a sister or whatever you want to call it, because at the end of the day, this watch has been around for probably 100 years. So it has their time, you know, it has their history. And also, of course, it was by the same founder. And I really think we're looking at Tudor right now as we used to look at Rolex probably 10, 20 years ago. So my personal opinion, like I say, I don't know, this is something that is going to happen, but I think these particular watches, they're eventually going to keep, you know, adding more value to them, because of course, all these market are barely starting to go more for Tudor. I think one of the things that is happening is the craziness that is happening with Rolex. You cannot find these watches. So a lot of people, I think they're really trying to go for Tudor, taking in consideration that it's practically the same or very similar quality than a Rolex, and very nice looking piece. And of course, these are not cheap watches. You're talking about $3,000-$4,000. I know it's quite an amount of money, but I think at the end of the day, probably, hopefully I'm right. So in 5-10 years, hopefully I can take a look at this video and say I was right. So I think this watch is going to continue going up in price. Right now, the price tag, it's only 4,300, but I've seen these watches online because I always try to check it out before I give you guys some of the information. Of course, I'm not right all the time, so if I'm wrong and I'm telling you something that is not true, please let me know in the comments below. I will really appreciate that, because like I said before, this channel is for all of us to learn together. So at the end of the day, Tudor Silver Case, I think it's a very cool watch. I think Tudor made a really cool move, and also they have a clear back. Like I said, that's kind of like the signature from Tudor. This is kind of like what they're going to let the difference between Rolex and Tudor. We have never seen a Rolex clear back case as long as I don't remember seeing one. Probably at least not in the near past, right? But at the end, I think this is a nice watch. It really fits very cool. I like how it fits in my wrist. The leather band, I think it's a weird color. I love it because it's between black and brown. And I think you can always use it with anything like blue or jeans or wearing black, or at the end, it's just an accessory. You can wear it with Crocs and nobody will tell you anything. At least that's what I think. I love 39 millimeters. I think I would love to see this in a 40, but I think 39 is perfect. We're going back to small watches. That's one of the things that I think is really going to happen in the future. And that's one of the things that Rolex told us actually in one of the last meetings when they released the Explorer 36 millimeters. That's one of the reasons that supposedly they created that watch in a smaller version, because in the future we're going back to small watches. So let's see how it's going to happen. Let's see what happened in the future. As far as today, this is a cool watch, and I've seen it on the market for around retail price. And the most expensive one I've seen is probably around $7,000. I don't know what's the difference, but I think this watch is really holding its value, and we think we're going to continue seeing that probably for the next few years. Like I'd say, I really hope all people can really find what they're looking for. And of course, me as a salesperson, hopefully I can help you find what you're looking for and build your collection, help you build your collection anyways. And I just wanted to give you guys a quick closer look to this amazing watch so you guys can see what you think. And I think that's all I have to say about the watch. I just wanted to be here on the Tudor webpage, but I hate this page. It's not the same. I think that's all I have to say, my friends. Please tell me what you think. You think this is a nice watch? Do you like this watch or not? I really want to see the new one, the other one that it's, this is the sterling silver, but they created another one that it's all gold with green. I think that would be really amazing. And if you ask me, I would love to see in my collection having the silver case, having the bronze case, and having also the gold case. I think that would be super, super nice. And of course, like I say, probably I exaggerated in my last video. I will definitely think this is a best investment. This is a much better investment. But of course, like I say, we don't know what's going to happen in the future. Like, you know, like we used to think the Rolex Hulk all green dial was ugly. And then what happened? Everybody wants the watch now. So let's see how it's going to be in the future. If you buy this today, you pay $4,300. And if you buy this today, you pay around $3,500, $3,400, around that. Not sure exactly the price right now. But let's see how it's going to be in the future. Let's see how it goes. And I'm really, really excited to take a look at the other models for Tudor. So I think that's pretty much it for today, my friends. Thank you very much for staying till the end. Thank you very much for watching. I would really appreciate a like I said in the beginning. Thank you very much. It's free. And wait for the next video, because I really have a lot of watches that are already recorded. So I'm just waiting for those videos to be ready. So stay on top, and thank you very much. See you next time.